Well, the transplant, I don't remember. Your mom would have to say for sure, but I know they were living by the phone. We didn't have cell phones in that era, you know, of, so basically you had to stay around home. And that was a bit of a nuisance, but he was unwell enough that he's on the list. And then it's a constant, how far am I on the list?
And he had a beeper.
He had a beeper, that's right.
He had a beeper at one point. That's what he was waiting on us for, it to go off and tell him that it was a go. Yeah.
So you couldn't go very far away and you couldn't really do much because you had to be prepared anytime. And also it means you're feeling very unwell because you're on minimal kidney function at the time. So your life kind of revolves around this stage. When he got his kidney transplant, I went down the next day because I remember I was going to Cheryl's house. It was in April, right? And I was going down to Cheryl's house because something was going on with Cheryl. Cheryl and I have always been kind of like a codependent support group. So I was going down to see Cheryl. And your dad had his transplant, so I went down to see him before I left for Halifax. And he was, my memory being a physio, I'd worked down at Mount Sinai, and transplants were on high precautions, because you didn't want them to get infections and you didn't want anything. So we had reverse isolation at that time, because you might be taking bugs in, rather than the person in isolation having bugs. So it was a reverse isolation, big procedure. So I went down to Toronto General and your dad's not in his room. So it's like right away, oh no, he's walking in the hall. So went down the hall. Actually, were you with me?
I think I was.
I think you were with me. You're just, you talk. Anyways, we went down the hall and found him and he's out walking with his IV pole the day after his transplant. So then we went downstairs to the link between the hospitals and had pizza, which was like full of salt, pepperoni pizza, full of salt. And it was so different than what I had expected. I thought reverse isolation, masks and gowns and, you know, beeping machines and everything. And he was out walking and already looking better. And then he was allowed to eat whatever he wanted. So off we went downstairs and
pizza.
Just never forget, he had pizza, which was full of salt and regular cheese and everything. And it was like, he was so excited. And then I didn't see him until he was home again because I went down to see Cheryl. But it was a great memory to take down because we had been, the whole family had been waiting for so long. So yeah, I think you were there too.
Yeah, I was. I do remember that. Mm-hmm. I don't have much of a memory anymore, but when you mention something, then I'll go, yeah, I guess I was there. Yeah, I remember that. I don't remember that, but yeah, I remember that. Mm-hmm.